1, 2, 3. You got about 5, 6 ambulances.
Command center.
Okay.
No, no. This looks like it's more like they've been here for a while now. And they've got.
This is the right place, right?
Oh, this is the media conference.
Thank you. Okay, I live on the 18th floor of the kitchen, which faces south, and I heard a really loud explosion. I felt the building shake, and then I looked out, and I saw bricks and debris and something else fly by. hang on a second. I'll call you back. Goodbye. And I ran out onto the balcony and I looked down to see on the 9th floor there's 2 tennis courts, and the tennis courts, one of the railings around it has been smashed down, and on the tennis court there's lots of brick, and there was also like a big piece of roof sheeting sort of thing. So I sort of figured it had to come from right up top, because no one else would have that sort of covering. And then the next minute the alarm was like evacuation, get out, and I walked out to the hallway, and there was lots of smoke, because each individual has their own air conditioning unit, but there is an air conditioning duct that goes right down the whole building, and there was lots of not smoke, but like debris, and because there was bits of rubble, and that was and the whole place was chopped. It was quite smoking, or quite dense, I should say. I knocked on everyone's door on my floor to make sure that there was no one still left there, because there's some old people. No one was there, so I went down. I got down here, ran into a couple of other people that live on in the building. One guy lives on the 23rd floor, and he said when he came out, all the pipes had burst, and there was water going everywhere on his floor. And he went into the stairwell, and there was a guy there that had blood on his face. I don't know how bad that was. There was that. And
what were you doing at the time, and how did it make